Hi guys, Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive. It is now 2024, day two. We are in the Dean booth, which is an oasis of peace. Seems like a strange move for a noisy brand like Dean Guitars,
yes.
But it's very welcome. We're with the almighty Chris Canella, who we last saw leaving a bar in Anaheim in April. I'm glad you made it.
I'm glad you made it as well. That was a challenge.
Dude, your size to mine.
That was a trip. So listen, Chris, it's great to see you. Yeah. You've got some really exciting shit for us this year. Sorry, we've sworn that far into the video. You can bleep that out, I'm sure. You got some really exciting stuff for us this year. We're stood in front of the really high-end, one-off US pieces. You want to tell us about what you have on the wall?
I do. This is great. So this year, one thing I love to do, we all do as a team, is like at the USA headquarters in Tampa, Florida, it's our custom shop is there as well. So we sit down with the woodworkers, with the painting team, with the assembly guys, and we say, hey man, what are we gonna do this year? Let's come up with 8 pieces, 9 pieces, 10 pieces that just say, F you, we're Dean.
Yeah,
and
nice.
So it's not just like one of us sitting there going, this is what I need to be made. These guys are all involved. So like, let's try this, and like this one right here, I think is killer.
Oh yeah.
Because Sharon came up with the concept of the paint, Dan Russell came up with the wood, and then of course Andy over in Final Assembly is like, hey man, let's put some gold top pickups in there, let's try these type of wooden rings, you know, all this kind of stuff. And we're going to do that. You know, everybody's a team on this. And then when it came out, it was originally supposed to be kind of a honey burst. And we looked at it and I said, oh, F no.
No.
I'm from Arizona. Mm-hmm. That looks like tequila.
Nice.
This is an añejo. So we're now, that's
Superb.
An añejo burst.
Love it.
And it's just a beautiful piece of quilt. Killer. Just like all the components are great. But the everything that went into it with the team, these guys just, you know, and look at even the painted logo. It's a custom logo.
Oh, so this is painted. This is not.
Yeah.
Wow. That looks
and
tremendous.
The team is just so much fun to do this stuff with.
Mm.
I mean, an all Paduke ML right above it.
Beautiful.
It's like when you, it's not very often you say, you know what, I have this giant piece of Paduke. Let's make an ML out of it.
Yeah, that's true, man. That is one piece on that top.
Yeah.
That's wild. You're going to need a big old sheet of very rare.
And we had enough to put it in the inlays and on the headstock. It was just ridiculous.
Well, that would have came from here and here and here. And
right.
Yeah. Wow, man. That is absolutely tremendous.
And then.
So how much does that thing weigh, just out of interest?
It's not Paduke's, heavy. It's
right.
Not bad.
Okay. Because it's a big old guitar, but I mean, I guess Paduke's not a super heavy wood.
It's not like, we have some mahoganies when people ask for it, when they said they want a heavy wood.
Mm-hmm.
We can make one that'll be 18 pounds for you.
Yeah.
It'll shrink me even shorter than I am, but, you know,
yeah, you're sure. Are you sure you want that?
Yeah, exactly. But. So, I mean, even down here, look at this Cadillac. It's a 6-in-line Cadillac. 25.5-inch scaling, so long scale, but with a Floyd. Again, these were all designed by the team. We came in, they're like, hey man, we got this killer, you know, piece of like ribbon mahogany. Let's do a satin back.
Beautiful.
With a gloss top.
Nice.
And, you know, it's just that's the exciting part about doing what we get to do.
I bet, you know, and if you have great people you know, designing and building these things, it's nice to turn them loose and just say, hey look, what do you want to make? What's your vision for how this guitar should be? And I guess does that inform where you go with production models? The things that
we're
doing here.
That's what
we're
doing right here. Man, you just stepped
right
into it.
Hey,
look at that.
I've done this before.
So these two started off as just like little one-off things. Like Dan was like over in the custom shop, let's do something that's like a mix of old school Dean from the 70s, like with the V back shape, the short scale length, but combine it with the new modern Vengeance and Zero.
Mm.
So It's like a halfsy, you know, like half old, half new. And it also has like a classic aesthetic to it.
I love it.
Andy was like, hey man, let's do these cool gold cover ones. And he hand wound these Baker Act and Nostalgias for these.
And okay.
So it's a combination of both. I don't know. And now because of that, and because it was so easy to make for USA, they're like, it really wasn't pain in the ass. So now these are USA production models.
Wow.
So that's going to go into the line. Eventually, we're going to make imports out of them.
That's tremendous. I love that. I love the idea that you have, you know, you start with the big vision and you go, hey, listen, you're the man. What do you want to make?
Yeah.
And then it ends up being, finding its way through all of the lines. I think that's really killer. And I love the idea that these are, you know, if you were to go back to the 70s in an alternate timeline, this is maybe what would have been made.
Right.
You know, so that's really, really great. I want to ask you about these pickups. These are hand-wound.
Yes.
And that's something that, again, we're going to start to see maybe a production version of? Or?
We don't talk about it enough, but we have our own hand winding area in the headquarters of Tampa, Florida, so we can hand wind anything we come up with. And the guys have tried different things. So Andy and Ben have been like experimenting, and Pat Baker, they're experimenting with like ideas of like true single coils that are independent that they connect to make a humbucker, and you can split them and turn them into a single coil, or you mix and match them. One coil is this output, one coil is this output. When you split it, it makes this kind of a output. So, you know, all these fun things. Almost like, it's almost like, it's not true, but it's almost like they sat around and just like burned one off at lunch and said, "Let's
try this."
You know? But they're always being creative. Coming up to me and they're like, "Hey, man, we got this. We got this." And it's so much fun. It's like, they make my job so easy. I come in and I meet with everybody every morning, and they're just like, every day, "What's going on, man? I had this idea last night." And of course, we're going to sit down and listen. I'm going to hear everybody.
That's great, man.
You know?
I mean, that's...
Even this. This was an MD-22, and Dan was like, "You know, I found this killer piece of mineral-stained maple." It's totally... This is actually a flaw. But we were able to cut a pick guard out of it and the body and make it from the same slab. And he's like, he just came up with the whole thing. I said, "Dude, just come up with it."
It's so interesting to describe it as a flaw, because, I mean, that's according to who? Because it looks gorgeous.
Right.
You know, like, that's a feature.
So
that's not a bug.
If we as a team were to put this mineral stain on the top of an ML, people would cry about it. "Oh, the color changes." You do it on purpose, and you tell everybody it's a mineral stain. They're like, "Oh, that's exotic."
That's nice. Yeah. It's bizarre, isn't it?
So, I mean, of course we're bringing the Doyle out. The main reason why I still have the Doyle out here, and we all have seen the Doyle for the last few years, it didn't make it. We do have an import version of this coming out. And Doyle will be at the headquarters next month, and we're going to start working on a couple of pieces together. He's going to work with us in the wood shop.
Very cool. I mean, this is such an iconic guitar, man.
It is.
I love the dedication to making the least comfortable guitar ever made. You know, it's like, this is... But, you know, I mean, that's Doyle. You know, he is who he is. We love him to death. And it's such an iconic design. I love that you've kept all the, you know, like the guys in the back. I love that they're... Are they stickers or are they inlaid?
Huh?
Are they stickers or are they inlaid?
No, they are. They're hand painted.
Oh wow! Okay.
Yep.
Man.
They're all hand painted.
Love it. Love it.
Out.
Killer. So this is the U.S. production model. What do we production models rather? What do we have over this way? So we're starting to work our way.
We're gonna get into artist stuff. I just want to show one little thing. Sure. That's a great story. This is the last little thing I'm gonna show you in USA. That is a really fun thing. This is our tribute to our original, we call him the original fearless leader, the man who brought Dean from the dead, Elliot Rubinson. When he was playing with UFO and all these other bands, he had this hybrid bass. And the coolest thing about it is, like, it's exactly the way he had it with the two output jacks. You can go stereo, you can go mono. All that stuff is great. Ebony inlay, these are all just ebony fret markers. And the paint job on it, originally, was painted by a girl in Wisconsin, and we sent out three or four of them back in the day, way before my time. Elliot had them painted, they come back. Well, to make a full story, or make a long story short, she's our painter now at the headquarters.
Oh, wow.
At the paint booth that we opened up a few years ago, she came along and we said, "We want to do an Elliot bass as a tribute to him," and she said, "What do you know? I still have the drawings. I can do that myself."
Oh, wow.
I said, "Wait a second. That's great. Did it? I thought it was outsourced." She's like, "No, I did that."
That's tremendous.
So it's like a full circle thing.
That is very
cool.
So
there's to you, Elliot.
Very, very cool.
Thank you for bringing us, and, you know, thanks for giving me a job.
Love that. That's tremendous. Super cool.
Into artist world.
Yeah, because you guys have got loads of really exciting artist stuff coming this year.
Yeah.
And this is just the first batch.
Right.
Right.
We're going to have batches of stuff throughout the year. So just to give everybody a heads up, we love being here. We're happy that NAMM is great again. We're happy that it's all going like old school again. But we're not limited to NAMM. We are going to be releasing product throughout the year. With technology today, you can tell a story any day of the month. I can call you up and say, "Hey, I got something going on. Let's make a stink together."
Nice.
And you guys are going to jump on.
Sure, 100%.
So right here is the import version of the Kerry King Overlord. It is so good. I was sending Kerry pictures, and he was like, "No effing way." I said, "Yeah, dude, that's your import." He's like, but it's exactly like my USA. Is it close enough? It just doesn't have the sustaining act. Everything else is the same. Inverted cross inlays with the pentagrams. He was like, that looks amazing. We even use these metal logos. It's hard to see in this lighting, but the logos are made of metal, just like on those USAs.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Those are actual metal logos.
Wow. It looks really cool, man.
One of our oldest friends, Carl Sanders from the band Nile, he's been around. He's been a diehard Dean guy his whole career. Like, I remember, it's like 15, 16 years ago, he was going out on tour, and I was living in Phoenix at the time, and he's like, hey, man, can I use your jam room to rehearse for this big tour that was coming up? He came in, he was playing Deans. The whole band was playing Deans, and he wasn't even endorsed.
Oh,
so
wow.
He is just, he has just been a Dean guy. So now we came out with this new Carl Sanders, his V in a 7-string, the Onk, so it's a little subtle.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you can tell it's Carl Sanders. The only difference between this and the production is that it's going to have these limited edition Carl Sanders Invaders from Seymour Duncan that have gold pull pieces.
Oh, yeah. You know, that's, yeah, they're doing the limited edition Invader this year.
Yeah.
So that's very cool. Very cool. So the production will have the black pull pieces.
No, the production will have the gold.
Oh, the production will have the gold. Fantastic. Yep. Very
so
cool.
It's killer. They're releasing an extra batch just for us.
Nice. That's great.
And then one of the biggest comebacks of the last few years is Mudvayne.
Yeah.
And have they come back and just nailed it? Greg happens to be one of the most easiest going people on the planet. So these are different than his USA customs that are on stage. We made a few subtle changes. And what did he say about it? Cool.
That's nice.
Awesome. So it was like, whoa. So these are both from the metallic red satin with black binding, black satin with red binding. You know, obviously the red pickup rings, everything about it, and the Mudvayne inlay and the Mudvayne stamp on the body.
Very cool.
These things are great. Soft C necks, very performance driven. Mm. This is exactly what he uses, like on stage, the same exact spec that he uses on stage.
Well, this is the great thing about companies that really work with artists like yourselves. You know, it's not, when you're getting an artist guitar, you're not just getting an off the peg model with somebody's stamp on it. These are designed in collaboration with the artist, so you know you're getting something that works, something that you know the pros are taking out, relying on night after night.
Everything that we've done with Kerry King, and since I've become the brand manager of the brand, every time Kerry comes down, we're cutting wood with him.
Wow.
Like, we're sanding stuff, and he's like, oh man, it's getting close, let's keep going. Photos of us working around the wood shop together. Same thing. We're calling up Carl, sending him pictures. Hey, man, what's going on? Is this right? Are we getting close? Oh, man, it's getting close. Or, you know, what's
very cool.
Greg was the same way. We made a prototype, two or three of them. We found the one that stuck.
Mm.
And that's going on to everything that he does.
Fantastic.
And then
love
even
it.
More.
Even more artists.
Yes. John
These
Knight
are beautiful.
From Anthrax and Shadows Fall.
Mm-hmm.
Shadows Fall is a new album coming out. Mm. And these are 100% designed with him, same thing. He wanted an Exile, but he wanted his own twist on it. He likes maple fingerboards, he likes reverse headstocks, he doesn't like tremolos, but he does like hip shots, he likes Fishman Fluence, and we just kind of went through and we, you know, did the thumb wheel on them. Everything about these are 100% with him, and they're super light, they sound great, and he's got a great year coming up between Shadows Fall and Anthrax in the same year.
Oh, wow.
So,
yeah, no kidding.
This is crazy.
So you're going to see these guitars absolutely everywhere.
Yep.
Kill
it. And right below that, one of the, if you have ever, you know, you think of the word hardcore music, what's the first name that comes to mind? Hatebreed.
Sure.
So Wayne Lozenak from Hatebreed, we got his two models in white and black, exactly like his USAs that he plays on stage. Mm. These are available in USA and import, just like all of these.
Yeah.
Available in both. There's a long scale thoroughbred, 24 frets. So it's a 25 and a half inch scale length, 24 frets, trem and non-trem, EMG 81 and 85.
Classic.
And I think this is great because he's got a volume, tone, and then a kill switch.
Nice.
Instead of another
tone.
Yeah,
instead of having the kill switch trick, you can, nice. Very cool.
And that's on both. Got his name up there. He's been here the whole weekend. He played last night with us at Metal Allegiance. He did a song or two. I did the song with Mastodon. He's very cool.
You were telling me about that. And you played Blood and Thunder.
Yes.
Yeah, very cool.
Right below that, one of the longest driving endorsees of this brand, John Conley from Seven Dust.
Mm.
And
well, we're big Seven Dust fans here at the magazine. Our editor-in-chief, Jonathan in particular, he's a really big fan. We love those guys.
They are, like, believe it or not, when their first album came out, them and my old band released our albums simultaneously on a three-story riverboat going down the Mississippi River at a thing called the Gavin Radio Convention.
Very cool.
The two of us played, and we released our albums that day to a room full of music executives who gave zero F's about who we were or anything about it. All we did was got tore up afterwards in Louisiana and New Orleans.
Nice.
And just talked about, hey, man, you know, your album's killer. Well, yours is killer.
Your album's killer, yeah.
And we've been friends ever since.
Fantastic.
And he has been a loyal, loyal, loyal Dean guy to the point where I was working for another company many years ago, and I actually approached him. Would you like to play this product instead? He's like, no way, man.
Dean.
I'm Dean.
Nice.
This is long before my time.
That's very cool.
And he's still here, and he's the real deal. So there's the new artist offerings, and we got more of that coming.
Nice. Waves and waves of coming. But again, that sort of story, that is testimony to how much these people love these guitars. You know, the idea that artists do tend to jump around brands, but, you know, when you have folks who've been with you since day one and will not be swayed by, you know, even by their friends,
right.
You know, that's really testimony to what you have going on
exactly.
here.
Exactly, and I'm glad you absorbed that and got that. It's a big deal. So this is kind of an overlook, which we've all seen, of the Select Series, but the main point of showing this off of the Select Series is that one thing that me and the team have really gotten behind, and that is, these are pro-level guitars.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're doing pro-level stuff on everything, so we raised the standard a little bit, so every Select Series you get going to have ebony fingerboards, you know, top-notch pickups, whether it be EMG, Fishman Fluence, Seymour Duncan, large glow in the dark side, large glow in the dark side dots, stainless steel frets, whether it be an Evertune, like this is a Babbitts, we're using a lot of Babbitts right now.
Nice.
There's massive surface contact on there. Look how much area the string has. And they sing. They sound so good, it's ridiculous.
It makes a difference, man. You know, it's become very fashionable. In the last few years to try and distill the sound of a guitar down to a pickup.
It's like,
this is a hill I'm prepared to die on. It's not true. The guitar is a system. These things matter.
It does.
For sure, you know, and the Evertune thing, to be able to get that on a guitar at a very affordable price point with these pro features, not cheap guitar by any stretch, but this is a big deal. You know, if you're recording metal in the studio, this is the new standard.
It is, and I've seen, and it's crazy, one of the new things about this that has evolved in the music industry is like in hardcore bands.
Mm.
You know, I've seen a lot of them. I'm not going to say by names, but they're great dudes who I've grown up with, and, you know, and you'll see these guys using the mode where you can't bend on the first three strings, on the low three strings, so that they can jump off of cabinets. They're kicking, they're spinning, they're having a great time, but they can still play leads on these three and bend on them.
Nice.
So
that's
like
a good idea.
A new wave of things. It's like everybody's coming up with ways to make that their own.
Nice. That
that's
is a really
cool
idea.
That's just one of the examples. So like these in the studio, if you have a keyboard or tracking, you put it into no bend mode and you're always on
you're in.
Point.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, this is the, I was chatting to somebody last night about this actually, and it's the challenge of working in, certainly in modern metal, where everything's gridded, and everything's timed and tuned, you can't really, you can time a guitar, but you can't really tune a guitar in post if it's playing chords.
Right.
It can't be. So something like this is game changer, as opposed to, you know, getting in, punching in for every chord. Okay, we'll tune it for the D, we'll tune it for the E flat. Yeah, it's a chore, and this, it makes it reliable, and you can take that out on stage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've heard of so many stories back in the day of, like, you know, original death metal bands from the UK and stuff like that having to track everything below the 12th fret on one track and everything above the 12th fret on another track just to get it to stay in tune because the intonation of a natural guitar is wrong.
Sure.
So
that's it.
This fixes a lot of that.
That's wild. Very cool. Very cool.
Keeping in the performance line, we originally released this as a Satin, but we never got, with everything that's gone on over the last few years, we never really got the stock of them. So I said, you know what, let's do this in gloss real quick. I just want to see when one. It showed up 2 days ago. This is the first time we've seen
man.
It. Oh, and
it looks tremendous.
This thing is just smoking.
Look at that. That's wonderful.
We love doing this on this because, like, this is a modern and a classic, so we're mix-matching stuff.
Interesting. Because that classic neck, like, a lot of the guys who have artist sets will have an artist bridge pickup.
Mm-hmm.
But the classic neck is just it. It's great. We don't want to change this. This is fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I am a nerd about neck pickups. Like, I love it, because I love using neck pickups on leads and stuff like that, and position of them, and I think that the Fishman Fluence Classic and the neck pickup is a must.
I agree, totally agree. And it's, again, this is something myself and Jonathan talk about at length, is neck pickups seem to be really hard to get right for, they're so often they're boomy, or and that works for some things.
Some people are 22 fret neck pickups, some people are 24 fret, you know.
This seems to work in either position.
I agree with that. Yeah. This is one that this is one of the few that do.
Yeah, and you have the second voice as well, so if you want that big, thick, John Sykes kind of thing, it's there.
And no matter how hard you try, it ain't going to be John Sykes, it'll get you close enough.
Disclaimer, doesn't mean you can play like John Sykes, but you'll get that, yeah, for sure. We've had that in a few streams, to be fair, where, you know, somebody, oh, do John Sykes. And if I'm playing my Fluences, I will literally just pop the neck pickup up and go, how do you get that tone? I'm like, well, there's a switch.
You're like, I'm English.
Right, next. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's exactly it. You live around the corner from my house. Nice.
So, obviously, you know, we've seen a lot of this, you know, the Exile, the Thoroughbred, these new Nash Vegases that are just, you know, they're just rock and roll beasts.
Nice.
Again, stainless steel frets, large glow-in-the-dark side dots, all the same attributes of the Slick series. Just sort of like a little, you know, hip fashion thing that's going on with the mint green and the shell pink.
I'm into it. I mean, we love the Nash Vegas. This is one of the first review guitars that we had from you guys in my tenure in the magazine. And we still have it. I think James plays it. James is our cameraman.
That's
great
awesome.
Guitar player. He loves it. I love it. It's they're great guitars. I love the green and the pink. Very on trend.
Roasted maple, you know, overly cooked. Look how dark those things came out. That's crazy.
Yeah, man. Beautiful.
So, this is the classic series. So, this is like the ML79s. You know, stuff right in that mid-tier. And, which is honestly kind of our core for a long time, this, you know, this mid-price point. We just, one thing that we're focusing on is we're not afraid to say who we were. We know where we're going. I just showed you everything where we're going. But we still pay homage to where, you know, we've been.
Yeah.
And what gave us the legs that we're able to stand on now. So ML79, Floyd TBZ with a flame top. People said, no more quilt, we want a flame. So we got to, you know, it's very subtle things.
Nice.
Everybody's like, why don't you have a black without a Floyd? Okay, here's your classic black. Hey, remember that old Silver Burst from the 1980? Okay, here you go.
Yeah.
And, you know, obviously the Dean Slime. So, you know, for lack of a better term, obviously this is, you know, a familiar aesthetic, but the fact is, it's an ML79.
Yeah.
And it's all it is, and it was around long before me. So, you know, the classic series we're keeping that is just like classic models.
Well, the classics for a reason, you know. I mean, this is literally what I think of when I think of Dean guitars.
Right.
The flame top of the burst.
Exactly.
The ML, yeah. And that's something we've heard from a lot of the brands we spoke to this weekend already, is the importance of honoring those classic designs.
That's right.
Because people will freak. You know, if you overhaul the entire range and go, yeah, listen, those guitars that you love, we're not making those anymore.
Right.
Like,
exactly.
It's a bold move that rarely pays off.
And I'll be the first one to admit, I've made that mistake myself. And
I think a lot of people have.
You know, I've put out product and I was like, who cares about that? And then you find those people that actually
you find
hurt,
out who cares about that.
Even if they weren't buying them, you hurt their feelings by not having them there.
Yeah.
And it's something that's very important to them. People that are friends or brand loyalists in guitars or any instrument you have, they look at things on a very emotional level. And you can't F them over.
Sure.
You know? So, you know, I've made the mistake. Everybody has. So we're always going to keep our core here. No matter where we evolve and what we do and try new stuff and crazy custom shop stuff, we'll always keep our core around.
That is important, man. That's good to know. Well, listen, Chris, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.
We're really looking forward to getting hold of some of these in our London studio. We'll be checking out some of these guitars in full. But we want to know from you guys. Drop us a comment down below. Let us know which guitar you're most excited for us to check out. If there's any particular one you want to see, let us know. We'll try our best to make it happen. I know which ones I want to get my hands on, but I'm keeping that a closely guarded secret. Chris,
thank you
so much. We're looking forward to seeing what you guys have for the rest of the year.
And for all you out there, please also make a comment asking Nick for dance lessons.
That's the best you're getting. It is what time? Like 10:30? It's early. That doesn't make a difference to my dance skills.
That's right.
Listen, it's now 2022. My name's Nick. 2024. I've gone back in time with the dance. 2024.
You
my
made
name's
me
Nick
younger,
Dennison.
Yes.
Get on. There we go. Do I have less gray? No.
No.
My name's Nick Dennison with Guitar Interactive Magazine. Our NAMM coverage continues. Like, subscribe, hit the buttons. You know where to find them. We'll see you next time.
Cheers.